रत्नपीठे शुभे कल्पमूले सुखासीनमादित्य कोटिप्रकाशम् सदा जानकी लक्ष्मणोपेतमेकम् सदा रामचंद्रम भजेहम भजेहम्। हरिओम, नमस्ते, गुड इवनिंग। इट इज इंडीड एन इवनिंग we are all eagerly looking forward to. For today's Onward, March to Rama, Rajya distinguished lecture promises to amplify our campaign for an enlightened society, which is but our birthright. In the five lectures we have had since the launch of the campaign, we have broadly developed the path to redeem ourselves from the mundane and illogical rat race we seem to be trapped in. We saw how, being in the worldly career itself, we can advance towards freedom by blending competence with character. This blend is crucial for our sustained career success too. While competence is easier to acquire, character is tougher to acquire and even harder to retain in the face of temptations. Therefore, we must leverage Dharma, which is an indispensable tool to achieve sustained success, not only in our career, but also in life in general. Dharma is like tonic, which is bitter to take. Our first distinguished speaker, Padma Bhushan Dr. Mrityunjaya Atreya, the first Indian to earn a PhD in management from Harvard University, had said, adding, "But as one progresses, the tonic produces favorable honey-like results." Leadership plays an important role in shaping an orderly society. Sri Rama is the supreme ideal. Srimati Vishakha Hari, the second distinguished speaker, in her presentation highlighted Dharma from the story of Sri Rama that could help usher Rama Rajya in today's society. The first condition for an ideal rule, she said, was a state in which citizens are joyful. The state must be self-sufficient. There was no poverty under Sri Rama's rule, since the rich donated liberally to support the poor. The ministers were always engaged in the welfare of the citizens. They, the ministers, should be spiritually rooted and should have good preceptors, she had emphasized. They must not hanker after power, but rather they must be so good that power chases them. The third distinguished lecture, titled Organizational Dharma of Human Society, Lessons from Human Biology by Dr. Sudha Seshayan, underscored the importance of a structured framework for humanity to have a useful existence. Nature, she said, has its own dissimilarities, but these dissimilar components complement each other. Every cell and structure in biology is interested in doing its work alone, and one does not confront other cells or structures. The variable smaller units in the biological organism jointly form a large structure, the one comprehensive whole. This is the organizational dharma I find in biology, Dr. Seshayan concluded, and suggested, similarly, smaller units in society have the responsibility to collectively work towards a harmonious whole. That initiating a grand temple project that brings together the entire society is the way forward for India to regain herself in these times of great social and intellectual ferment, was the conclusion we at Tattvāloka drew from the fourth distinguished lecture by Dr. Chitra Madhavan. Our ancestors had envisioned a temple-centric society. The temple was the sacred space which portrayed everything from the arcane to the apparently mundane, just so as to make us realize the divinity of life, Dr. Madhavan said. History teaches us that when temples were built on a grand scale, at the same time education, literature, music, dance, all these took great strides. A beautiful aspect of this advancement was that it was not merely a case of the building of temples going on the one side and culture growing on the other. It was with the Lord as the base, with the temple as the center, that both education and culture developed. The supremely refined dance, Bharatanatyam, is verily a product of this temple culture. The last Onward March to Rama Rajya distinguished lecture by Dr. Padma Suresh clarified the real purpose of this dance. The basic element which invokes emotions in the performer and also that which links the audience with the performer is one and the same. The magical web called Rasa connects us all together, she declared. A true practitioner of dance, a Natyopasaka, she said, aims to immerse herself in that dance which scales the heights of Nada and attains perfection or Nadanta. Nadanta, the climax, is the removal of all ignorance. Just like the Vedantic seeker pierces through the panchakoshas or the five sheets, a dancer progresses from the physical to the emotional to the psychical and finally to the metaphysical sheets. He then sees his dance on the stage is the same as the vibration of the tiniest particle of matter and also as the cosmic dance of Lord Shiva. This is the ananda of Nadanta realized within by the practitioner of Natya. To awaken India through Harikatha, it is our honor for us at Tattvāloka to be partnering with the multifaceted genius Sri Dushyanth Sridhar. He is a man of conviction. His efforts to use his skills to make Sanatana Dharma appealing to the younger generation are particularly laudable. Steeped as he is in the timeless wisdom of our land, his Harikatha presentations make us realize how every moment of life is but a celebration of freedom. He is a leader I look up to. His gracious presence here today portends our readiness to take the campaign to the next level. As we continue marching ahead, I urge all of you to join the campaign by subscribing to Tattvāloka, which is a monthly magazine published in English and Hindi on behalf of the glorious Sri Sharada Peetham of Sringeri, established by Jagadguru Adi Shankaracharya. Tattvāloka is dedicated to spreading knowledge of the truth and the real values of life. I now invite Sri Dushyanth to take his rightful place on the stage and also call upon Ma'am Sharla Panchapakeshan ji and Sri R. Krishnamurti ji to come on the stage and honor and welcome our esteemed speaker with a flower bouquet.
Thank you. One second.